Today I'm going to demonstrate the Hall Effects sensor. This is a sensor that basically will take a magnetic field from this magnet and register that it's in proximity to it with this sensor. So in a moment I'll explain how the Hall Effects sensor actually works. But for now I'm going to show you what port we're going to use. We're going to use the X-Min port, but this is also the X-Max. This is the Y-Min. This is the Y-Max, this is the Z-Min, and this is the Z-Max. And inside of here, if you can see down inside the board, we have voltage for this pin, we have ground for this pin, and then we have signal for this pin. So in a moment, I'll explain the Hall Effects sensor and then show you how to connect it. Okay, this is a close-up of the Hall Effects sensor. Now the actual magnetic field is either detected on this side or on this side when a magnet is in proximity. The pins to connect, we have our voltage pin right here. It says V on the board. Then we have ground, which is the middle pin. And then the very end pin is our signal pin. So in a moment, I'll show you what wires we need to connect. What we have here, obviously, is our red for voltage, our black for ground, and then our green for signal. So to connect it to the board, what we're going to do is going to roll the board up here. And as you can see down below, we're going to go with our voltage, our ground on the second pin, and then signal. In a moment, I'll show you in Marlin how to actually load the firmware. Okay, before we can use the actual programming of the port, we have to connect the USB serial down here, and then we have to connect it to the computer, so you're going to hear a beep. Keep in mind, once the light is lit, you can't touch the board. So in a second, I'll show you in Marlin how to load the firmware. Okay, we're going to open up the Marlin 1.1.8. We're going to open up the Marlin subfolder. We're going to press M on the keyboard and scroll down to marlin.ino and press enter. We're going to select the configuration.h tab. We're going to do a find on use_xmin_plug and press enter. And as you can see, it's not commented out, so we can use that. So we're going to scroll down to where it says define Xmin end stop inverting is false. So we're going to change the false to a true. We're going to save that. We're then going to go over to tools, ports, make sure the COM4 is selected, which it is. And then we don't have to worry about the board. It's the same architecture as an Arduino Mega 2560. So all we need to do is press compile and upload. Okay, in the Pronterface folder, we're going to open up Pronterface.exe. We're going to connect to the printer board. And then first thing we're going to do is we're going to test to make sure the sensor has a setting of open, so we're going to type M119 and press enter. And as you can see, it's open. So now we're going to move the magnet close to the sensor and see what happens. And as you can see, it's turned red. So now we're going to type M119 on the keyboard again and press enter. And as you can see, it's triggered. So now we're going to move it away. And we're going to go go back into Pronterface and do M119 again. Now it says open. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.